Okay, now, so basically, just now I recap what we just did in the last couple of minutes. So I introduced to you this thing called the front panel. Okay, front panel. Remember the terms that I use, I say, front panel. Front panel means it's the interface. Okay, so called the graphical user interface, the front panel. Okay, where you interact with the machine, so called. So you will design this kind of thing, front panel. Okay, now you already done the... Okay, so we have also shown you that your lab view, this program, right? You have the front panel block diagram, right? So block diagram is the one that you put in your codes. Okay, now two more things I also shared with you earlier. Okay, very quickly. We talk about this thing called the control palettes. Okay. Now, the control palettes are found when you right-click your mouse at the front panel. Okay, where you see this, right? This thing, right? Just now you saw this, right? This is called the control palette because it allows you to put in controls objects, okay, or indicators, okay, in your front panel. Okay. So this is called the control palette. Control palette, remember? Control palette. Now, one more thing. Over here, just now I didn't explain very much, but I think you can more or less figure out by looking at this. Okay, this one is the what we call the run button. Very good. Run. When you click, you must run the program. You click this run. Okay, then you execute the run button. Now, don't use this. This one is called the abort button. So maybe in the beginning, y'all want to use this button to stop the program. Later, you'll see. This is called the abort button. So try not to use this button. Okay, there's a proper way to stop a program, which I'll show you later. Now, so basically, moving on, okay, the controls and indicators. Okay, just now we already explore. Okay, you can have different things like push buttons, graphs, LEDs. Okay, these are on the instrument itself, right? The instrument, right? Not instrument. So these are called the controls. The other one is called the indicators. Okay. Now these are further some examples how to differentiate between controls and indicators. Indicators are stuff that the program will display on the screen. Controls are the user must enter. For example, just now you all type the number, right, on the X, and then the other one is the Y, right? That one is called the controls. I type in 10 and then another 10 here. So when then it goes through the multiply function, remember? 10 times 10, right? The output is the 100, right? 100 is the indicator. Any joke want to share with me? Ladies, try to follow. Okay, thanks. Okay, so this one is the indicator, the output. Okay, so there's a difference between controls and indicators. Try to remember, control, indicator. Okay, then you have buttons and so on. Now, I do have, if you look at your PowerPoint slides, if you do have the slide now, there are a series of those videos, training videos. You can watch it offline because we don't have time to do it in class. There are a couple of those videos that you can watch it. You all got QR code? You want this QR code? Don't have your phone, got this QR code reader. If you want, you can scan. If not, you type in the same thing. You can click on this. They got this several videos. Quite interesting. Very good videos. Okay, let me show you a brief one. Okay, now this company, National Instrument, they created a lot of training videos. You can go and watch. Okay, or even on YouTube. Okay, you can see many, many stuff. If you want to even be more familiar. Let me log in. I'll just show you a sample. Okay, you can see something like this. Now I can tell you this tool is a very, very powerful tool. I'll keep emphasizing it. You all are very lucky. You all are learning this, really. Okay? In fact, some of my students who graduate from my course already, right? This, they went out to do full-time LabVIEW programming. Okay? You will see. Many of them I can share with you. I can even invite them to come back and share with you all. Okay? So basically, there are some of these training materials that you can find. So these are some examples. Okay, you can follow the link. If you want, you can follow this link. You can go and see further examples. All right, so this is some videos. You just YouTube, go to YouTube, you just type LabVIEW, you have a lot of things. Okay, but let's go back to our lab sheet. Can we ask you to take a look at your lab one? Okay, let's do some work. Lab one. Yep. Okay, so if you have your lab sheet, lab one. Who don't have a lab sheet? Okay, you need a lab sheet. Lab one. Okay, let's try to work together on this one here. Okay, so you have this lab. So can I ask you to please fill up your name, your class, PA13. Now, there's this number called SN, do you see? Maybe it's good to tell you. Yeah, this number is your seat number. So if you do not know your seat number, let me also try to help you remember. Okay, your seat number is... these. Can you please fill in your seat number where you are seated? So one is on Celestine, right? Celestine on one, and then two and three and so on. So please fill in your seat number into that little circle there. Okay? To make it easy for everybody. Okay, so please fill in your seat number. Okay, then we take a look at the first lab exercise. Okay, so I'll try to help you over here. Okay, now I can share with you a little experience that I had last time when we were working with the defense industry. We had to work on board the naval ship. And I'm not sure, you all probably have not had a chance. The naval ship is very compact. It's similar to like an aircraft. Because the space is a luxury, premium. You don't have much space on board the ship, especially those missile boat. Okay, the one with the two harpoon missile. Okay, so those naval ships are very tight in space. So sometimes if you want to do some, because on board got a lot of electronics, on board the warship, a lot of electronics inside, you all cannot see. So if you want to bring instrument inside, you have a problem. Especially, you know how scopes, spectrum analyzer and those kind of things. You want to carry this kind of thing on board ship, very challenging. Okay, so that's why sometimes the Navy, they like to use very compact instruments. Compact instrument. Your laptop can be transformed to an instrument. No, I can tell you. You know that your laptop, if you buy the appropriate hardware cards, you can turn it into an oscilloscope. So let me. This is the exercise that we are coming at. Okay. So let me share with you. Now this one, I'm pretty sure you have seen this so many times, right? How do you find the instrument? Big and bulky, maybe. I'm not sure. Maybe now they got the small one. But even then, it's still bulky. Okay? Now, an instrument, right? As you can see, now this is just a simulation. I'm going to try to show you a simulation. This is you all know this instrument quite well, I think. You all have the display, right? You have the different buttons and knobs. Agree? So this instrument. Okay. Now, what you do is this. Now, I want you to go to this one. Can you go to your lab one folder? Your desktop machine, right? you have a folder called the SIN, right? October folder. Now there is a lab one. Okay, can you see this thing called the oscilloscope? Yeah, lab one, topic one, is it? Topic one. There's a thing called the two-channel oscilloscope. Can you all see this? Yeah, it should look something like this. If you expand it, can I ask you to open this thing? Okay, so what I've just shown you. Okay, you should see this. Can you all, the ladies, gentlemen behind one, can you all see this? Can you open this program? Open this program. Then you can click the run button. See this run? Click on this run button. Now you will see that this thing can run. Right, at least you must see something like this. Can you all see this? Is it running? Can you see this waveform, sine wave and the square wave running, right? Okay, now this is a virtual instrument itself. Okay, although this instrument currently is not connected to anything, right? Your desktop is not connected, my laptop is not connected to anything. I do see this virtual instrument in front of me. But there's no reason that I can stop me. I can connect this to the real world outside. I can. Okay, I can. But provided I must have a card, so-called. You must have some appropriate hardware you can plug into your laptop. Okay, if you have the data acquisition card, you slot it in, you immediately transform this thing, can be live. Okay, you can connect to, say, anything. I can connect to a transformer or anything. I want to connect to the speaker, I want to measure the signal output. I can do this. Now, try to play around with this thing. Okay, maybe I adjust the time base. I make it faster. So this, maybe 5 milliseconds. I want to display more waveform. Play around with it. Play around with this button here. Okay, so maybe I'll change the time base, 20 milliseconds. Okay, I see this. Then I change the vertical, right? The horizontal scale, voltage scale. Okay, so I can do this. Okay, you can see that. Not very clear on my screen, but probably if I minimize it a little bit. But you can see on your own screen. Okay, I can also look at the information. Okay, I can even want to see one sine wave only. I can do that. Can anybody all don't see this? Anyone don't see this? Can you see this? Can see, yeah? Okay, now, are there some questions at the bottom? Okay, so some instruction there. The first lab is quite simple. Everybody will get full mark. Okay, but as we progress, then there'll be things coming in. Okay, so basically, right, now over here, I want to just highlight two things only. Okay, what is a control? Okay, my question is, what is a control? What is an indicator over here? Can you tell me? Okay, so I erase this. Okay, my two question. Okay. Yeah, what are controls in here, in this context here? Okay, what are indicators? Maybe not many, I'll just put what is an indicator. Actually, there's only one indicator here. Okay, I'll give you the hint. Okay, you can see that. Okay, my question is this, what are controls? Okay, I read to you, what is an indicator over here? Which are the controls you think? Yeah, all the buttons, you're right. Correct, thank you. Thank you for that. Okay, rightfully said. Okay, all these buttons here, switches or knobs, if you like, okay, are all controls, right? The only indicator in this example, in what is that? The screen, correct. Very good. This is the graph, right? The graphical display for the waveform chart. That is an indicator, right? Because it displays the information coming out. You see what I mean? Okay, that is the indicator. Remember, there's a difference. Control are stuff that the user need to interact with. Okay, I can click the stop button. The stop button is a control. I can click on this more information. Okay, the channel, time base, and so on. Is that clear? This one very important. Okay, now can you tell me what is the exercise in your lab sheet? What did they ask you to do? Page 2, I think. Page 2. Take a look at the page 2, right? The bottom part, I think they ask you some question, right? Can you help me? Can you help answer those questions? Can answer or not? Can you read to me the question? What's the question? What are the names of the controls, right? Yes, thank you very much. Okay, so basically just put in. Just put in what are the controls, what is the indicator, right, in the question there. No, you write lah. For example, this whole thing is called a trigger, right? You can put trigger. Under trigger got source, slope, and level. You can play around. But write down what we want. You know what I mean? These are the controls, right? This one, position, is also a control, right? You get what I mean? Yes. You can put trigger. I help you. You put the word trigger, right? Under trigger heading, then you bracket. There are three of them. You have source, slope, and level, right? These are the different controls. So under position, then you bracket time base, comma, votes per division. Close bracket, for example. Okay, and so on. Is that okay? Can you all follow? So, triggers, position, channel, and so on.